हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू केमिस्ट्री फंडामेंटल्स। वी आर डीलिंग विद कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टीज। दी कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टीज, व्हाट आर कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टीज? सो रिमेंबर कि कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टीज आर दोज प्रॉपर्टीज विच डिपेंड्स अपॉन नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल, दोज प्रॉपर्टीज विच डिपेंड्स अपॉन नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल एंड चेंजेस विथ चेंज इन नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स आर टर्म्ड एज कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी। तो फोर सच प्रॉपर्टीज आर देयर। फर्स्ट इज रिलेटिव लोअरिंग ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर, वन इज रिलेटिव लोअरिंग ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर, अदर इज एलिवेशन ऑफ बॉइलिंग पॉइंट, द थर्ड वन इज डिप्रेशन ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट एंड थर्ड वन इज ऑस्मोसिस एंड ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर। सो वी बिगिन विथ रिलेटिव लोअरिंग ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर, द रिलेटिव लोअरिंग ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर। नाउ एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डेट विथ द वेपर प्रेशर, based on it we have discussed Raoult's law, so it is nothing but the extension of Raoult's law. In the previous videos I have dealt with vapor pressure, Raoult's law and the factor that affects the Raoult law. Now this topic is the extension of that Raoult's law, so you can just go through those videos just to aware yourself with the Raoult's law. We are dealing with relative lowering of vapor pressure. Now suppose if you have taken some solvent in a beaker, we have taken some volatile solvent in a beaker, and if we measure the vapor pressure of this solvent, if we take a volatile solvent in a beaker and we measure the vapor pressure of this liquid, suppose at 25 degree centigrade vapor pressure of this pure solvent is P0A. At 5 degree centigrade, suppose at a fixed temperature, vapor pressure of this pure solvent is P0A. Now, into this pure solvent, I have added non-volatile solute. So, when into solvent we add solute, it results in formation of solution. What is solution? Solution is a mixture. So, since solution is a mixture, therefore, it will have two components and both these components will have their mole fraction. So we have already dealt with mole fraction in the previous videos, the mole fraction. So you can refer those videos to just go through the mole fraction also. You can revise mole fraction through those YouTube videos. The previously I have done it. Now suppose this is now a solution having solvent and solute. Solvent and solute, in which solvent is volatile, solute is non-volatile. Since it is a mixture having two components, suppose mole fraction of solvent is XA, that of solute is XB. And suppose vapor pressure of this solution is PA. So when it was pure solvent, the vapor pressure was P0A. Now when into this solvent we have added solute, we have converted it into solution. Suppose at 25 degree centigrade, the vapor pressure of the solution is PA. We have already dealt with Raoult's law. Raoult's law says that vapor pressure of solution is equal to the product of PA is vapor pressure of solution. So Raoult's law says vapor pressure of solution is product of vapor pressure of pure solvent into its mole fraction. We have already dealt Raoult's law, which says that vapor pressure of solution PA is equal to vapor pressure of pure solvent into its mole fraction. So PA is vapor pressure of solution, P0A is vapor pressure of pure solvent, and XA is mole fraction of solvent, mole fraction of solvent present in this solution. Now since we know that sum of the mole fraction of all the component present in a mixture is always 1, that is mole fraction of solvent XA plus mole fraction of solute XB, together it is 1, so XA plus XB is equal to 1, or we can say XA is equal to, if I bring XB on this side, so it is XA is equal to 1 minus XB. So this is value of XA. Mole fraction of solvent XA is equal to 1 minus XB. If I keep this value of XA in this equation, If in this Raoult's equation I keep this value, it becomes, so therefore it becomes PA is equal to P0A into the value of XA. Value of XA is 1 minus XB. Value of XA, PA is equal to P0A into XA. Value of XA is 1 minus XB. Therefore PA is equal to P0A into 1 minus XB. If I open the bracket and solve it, so it will become this P0A is multiplied by 1, also multiplied by XB. So it becomes PA is equal to P0A into 1, that is P0A, P0A into XB, that is minus P0A into XB. Now if I change side, if I change the side, what I can write? I am bringing P0A into XB on left hand side and bringing PA on the right hand side. So it becomes, this minus become plus. So P0A into XB is equal to P0A minus PA. So what is PA? P0A, it is vapor pressure of pure solvent. PA is vapor pressure of the solution. And remember, the difference of two vapor pressure, the vapor pressure of pure solvent and that of the solution, this difference is called as lowering of vapor pressure. P0A minus PA. P0A minus PA is termed as lowering of vapor pressure. This is termed as P0A minus PA is termed as lowering of vapor pressure. Now if I bring P0A in the denominator, if I bring P0A in the denominator, then this P0A minus PA, P0A minus PA upon P0A, this much is called as relative lowering. So the difference of two vapor pressures is termed as lowering of vapor pressure. And when this difference is expressed with respect to vapor pressure of pure solvent, this difference is expressed with respect to vapor pressure of pure solvent, it is termed as relative lowering of vapor pressure. And remember, this P0A minus PA upon P0A, relative lowering of vapor pressure depends upon what? So it depends upon mole fraction of solute. XB is mole fraction of solute. So it depends upon mole fraction of solute. This XB is mole fraction of solute. And what is value of XB? So we have done in the mole fraction, that mole fraction of solute, that is XB, is equal to mole of B upon the total mole. XB is mole of B upon the total mole, NB upon NA plus NB. Therefore, if I keep value of this XB in the previous equation, if I keep this value of XB in the previous equation, it becomes P0A minus PA upon P0A, which is termed as relative lowering, is equal to NB upon NA plus NB. So this relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to mole fraction of solute, which is NB upon NA plus NB. Now, if the solution which we have prepared is very dilute, if solution we have prepared is very dilute, we say if solution is very dilute, then the amount of solute is very, very less as compared to amount of solvent. That is, mole of solute as compared to mole of solvent is very less. That is, NB as compared to NA is very, very small, provided a solution is very dilute. So if solution is very dilute, NB is very small as compared to NA. Therefore, NB can be neglected from the denominator. If value of NB is very, very small as compared to NA, we can neglect NB from the denominator. So if NB is neglected from the denominator, if NB is neglected from denominator, it becomes P0A minus PA upon P0A is equal to NB upon NA. NB from the denominator has been neglected. NB from the denominator has been neglected. So it is NB upon NA. Remember this equation, this equation is applicable to dilute solution. It is applicable to dilute solution. Now since we know that N is equal to W by M, N is equal to W by M, therefore NA is equal to WA upon MA, NB is equal to WB upon MB, N is equal to W by M, weight upon molecular weight, NA is equal to WA upon MA, NB is equal to WB upon MB, therefore equation becomes P0A माइनस पी ए अपॉन पी जीरो ए विच इज रिलेटिव लोअरिंग ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू वैल्यू ऑफ एन बी डब्ल्यू बी अपॉन एम बी अपॉन वैल्यू ऑफ एन ए डब्ल्यू ए अपॉन एम ए. इफ आई जस्ट सॉल्व इट आई कैन राइट पी जीरो ए माइनस पी ए अपॉन पी जीरो ए दैट इज रिलेटिव लोअरिंग ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू बी अपॉन एम बी डब्ल्यू बी अपॉन एम बी इन टू दिस एम ए गोज टू द न्यूमरेटर एम ए अपॉन डब्ल्यू ए. तो दिस इज द फॉर्मूला विच इज एप्लीकेबल टू कैलकुलेट कैलकुलेट रिलेटिव लोअरिंग ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर. दिस फॉर्मूला इज यूटिलाइज टू कैलकुलेट द रिलेटिव लोअरिंग ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर. सो हाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट द रिलेटिव लोअरिंग, वॉट इज रिलेटिव लोअरिंग. सो आई सेड वॉट इज लोअरिंग ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर, द डिफरेंस ऑफ टू वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ प्योर सॉल्वेंट एंड दैट ऑफ द सोल्यूशन. द डिफरेंस ऑफ टू वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ टू सोल्यूशन इज टर्म्ड एज लोअरिंग. When this lowering is expressed with respect to vapor pressure of pure solvent, this is termed as relative lowering. This is how we can calculate the relative lowering of vapor pressure. At the same time, same equation can be used to calculate the molecular weight of unknown solute. So this is formula to calculate the relative lowering. Same formula can be utilized to calculate the molecular weight of unknown solute. To calculate the molecular weight of unknown solute, which is MB. So in order to calculate the molecular weight of unknown solute, the formula becomes MB is equal to this P0A goes to the numerator, this comes to the denominator. So P0A upon P0A minus PA into WB upon WA into MA, this gives you the formula to calculate the molecular weight of unknown solute. This formula is also very, very important for the numericals. We practice numerical based on this formula.